Welcome students. In this video, we will discuss about the trait approach theory of personality. In the trait approach, the personality is viewed in terms of various traits. In our day-to-day conversation, we give traits to our friends and near ones as honest, shy, lazy, dull, etc. Traits may be defined as relatively permanent and relatively consistent general behavior patterns that an individual exhibits in most situations. These patterns are said to be the basic units of one's personality that can be discovered through observing one's behavior in a variety of situations. For example, if a person behaves honestly in several situations, his behavior may be generalized and he may be labeled as honest person. And honesty is then said to be a behavioral trait of his personality. The personality theories of Alpert and Cattles are said to be the best examples of the trait approach. In this, we will discuss about the British-born researcher Cattell's theory in detail. According to Cattell, the personality of an individual is a sum of combination of behavioral traits that can be discovered through the continuous and objective observation of his behavior. According to him, a trait is a structure of personality inferred from behavior in different situations. Cattell described about four types of such traits. 1. Common traits, Samanya Gun. Common traits are widely distributed in general populations. We depict them and show them through our behavior depending upon various situations. Aise Samanya Gun, जो सामान्य रूप से सभी में होते हैं और हर परिस्थिति में कहीं ना कहीं वो हमारे व्यवहार से झलकते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ऑनेस्टी, एग्रेशन, कोऑपरेशन, एक्सेट्रा. द सेकेंड वन, यूनिक ट्रेट्स, अनोखे गुण. यूनिक ट्रेट्स आर यूनिक टू अ पर्सन, सच एज टेम्परामेंटल ट्रेट और इमोशनल रिएक्शंस. ऐसे गुण जो कि सब में अलग अलग होते हैं और वो एक व्यक्ति को दूसरे से अलग करते हैं. हर कोई एक दूसरे से इन गुणों में अलग होता है और वो अपने व्यवहार में इन गुणों को दिखाता है, जैसे गुस्सा करना, शांत स्वभाव का होना, एक्सेट्रा. और कहीं ना कहीं ये हमें एक दूसरे से अलग करती हैं. थर्ड वन इज द सर्फेस ट्रेट्स, बाहरी गुण. द सर्फेस ट्रेट्स रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बाय द मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ बिहेवियर लाइक क्यूरियोसिटी, टैक्टफुलनेस, डिपेंडेबिलिटी एक्सेट्रा. दैट इज आवर आउटवर्ड बिहेवियर, वो व्यवहार जो हम सबके सामने करते हैं, उन्हें हम कहते हैं बाहरी गुण. द फोर्थ वन इज द सोर्स ट्रेट्स, यानी कि आधारभूत या मूल गुण. These are the underlying structures or sources that determine our behavior. For example, dominance, emotionality, etc. ये वो बुनियादी ढांचे और मूल गुण होते हैं जो कि हमारे व्यवहार को प्रभावित करते हैं. These were the four types of traits given by Cattell. The theory given by Cattell attributes certain specific dimensions to personality, so that the human behavior related to a particular situation can be predicted. He has adopted factor analysis as a technique of work. The theory given by Cattell attributes certain specific dimensions to personality, so that the human behavior related to certain situations can be predicted. In 1946, He compiled a list of 17,000 traits, and by eliminating similarities and synonyms, reduced the list to 171 traits related to personality and called it elements. He found that each trait element has correlation with others. He identified some 35 specific groups and called them surface traits. He further analyzed these surface traits in terms of their interrelations and eliminated those were overlapping. It gave him desired dimensions, which he called the source traits. These source traits were the real structural influence underlying personality. He used factor analysis to identify the surface and source traits and enumerated 16 factors as the building blocks of personality. This is one of the personality inventory known as Cattle 16PF. He tried to describe and predict the behavior of the individuals on the basis of their personality traits. His theory has given equal importance to the role of both heredity and environment in the growth and development of personality, and thus is able to demonstrate strong interactions between biological genetic factors and the environmental influence for the prediction of human behavior. However, this theory of cattle was criticized on the following grounds. Number one, the circulatory of the trait concept. That is, first defining traits in terms of observed behavior and then using it to explain the same behavior. Secondly, excessive emphasis was given on the overt behavior, that is the outward behavior. And lastly, the projection of static picture of human functioning. The theory has also been criticized for not making full use of the factor analytical approach to yield higher order factors for identifying fundamental categories or dimensions of personality. This was all about the Cattle's trait approach theory. Thank you for watching.